Hi everyone, my name's Beverly. Did you know that I grew up in Canada in the beautiful city of Toronto, but my parents are from Manchester in the UK? I moved to France, to Paris, just after university, and then to Madrid in Spain. And now I live in Portugal in the city of Braga. It has been amazing to live in these different countries. If you could live in any city in the world, which city would you choose? Let me introduce you to someone in our coursebook who has also lived in different cities and countries. This is Richard Zimler, and he's famous. Do you know him? What do you think his job is? Now, read the short text to find out. What do you remember about him? As you know, Richard is American. He's from a big city with tall buildings on the east coast of the United States. It's a very famous city, and you've seen it in films and TV series. Which city do you think it is? Well, if you said New York, then you're correct. What do you think living in New York is like? We're going to find out more about Richard and New York. We're going to watch a video interview with Richard. Are you ready? Look at exercise B and read the sentences that you have to complete. What type of information do you need to complete each sentence? A place? A date? A number? For example, in sentence one, you might need a country or a city. So read each sentence and write down what type of information you need. Now watch the interview and complete the sentences.
I was born and grew up in America. I was born just outside New York City. My parents were born in the city itself. My grandparents were from Poland, however. They immigrated to America around 1905. I grew up in the suburbs of New York in a small town called Roslyn Heights. It was about 4 miles east of New York City, east of the border between New York City and the county where I grew up.
Let's check our answers. Number one, Richard is from America. Number two, his parents were born in New York. Number three, his grandparents were from Poland. Number four, they went to the US in 1905. Number five, Richard grew up in a suburb of New York called Roslyn Heights. Number six, it's about 4 miles east of New York. Do you know what a suburb is? It's a residential area outside of the city. Now look at exercise C. We're going to find out more about Richard in part two of the video. Read the sentences. Now watch the video and circle the correct answer.
It was very quiet. The neighborhood had about 100 houses, lawns and gardens, and a very friendly atmosphere. And we felt very, very safe, which was great. Like I say, it was very safe and protected. There were only two ways in and out of our neighborhood, so everybody who came in lived there or was friends with someone who lived there. Like many American neighborhoods and small towns, the houses had lawns and gardens, and there were no walls or fences between them, so it created a very friendly atmosphere. Well, I especially liked the freedom and the safety of being able to play outside all day long. We were on our bicycles and we were playing sports and nobody worried about us. We would come home just when it got dark for dinner, and that was lovely. Both my parents liked to garden, so we had particularly nice trees and flowers and plants, and I helped sometimes. I would weed and prune, and it gave us something to do as a family.
Let's check our answers to exercise C. Number one, the neighborhood was very quiet. Number two, they didn't have walls separating the houses. Number three, Richard's neighborhood was very safe. And number four, His parents liked to work in the garden. Now, look at exercise D and read the questions. Look at question 4. Do you know what shutters are? Watch part 3 of the video and answer the questions.
My permanent home is Porto. I live in the Fares neighborhood, so right near the ocean and the Douro River, which is a big advantage because we have the beautiful views over the water and nice cool sea breezes even when it's hot in the rest of the city, and a very friendly atmosphere. Well, the Fares is a bit more active than Roslyn Heights, more stores, maybe a bit more dangerous because there's more traffic and more noise, so I'm not sure kids would want to play out on the street all day long. That would be pretty difficult. Also, in Porto and in Portugal, people keep their shutters and curtains closed so you can't see in, and I don't much like that. I like being able to, I don't know, to see what people are doing. I mean, we're all curious, and it's really nice in New York that nobody closes their shutters and windows, and you can see people having dinner and playing with their kids and what their dogs are doing. And that creates a particularly nice atmosphere. But on the other hand, I like the Fares. The shopkeepers all know me. I know a lot of the residents, and people say hi to me everywhere I go, so that's great. What do I miss about New York? That's a really good question. Well, I miss my friends and my family, of course. I miss the cultural offerings because New York City is a huge, huge metropolis. We have great world-class museums, lots of concerts, lots of theater. So I miss that. I miss being able to speak English all the time. It's my mother tongue, but mostly I speak Portuguese in Portugal, of course, and I forget English verbs and nouns and adjectives, which is kind of strange. And it's one of the reasons why I read so often in English. I also miss the birds, strangely enough, because I used to go bird watching a lot when I was a kid, and we have beautiful birds like cardinals and blue jays. And we also had a lot of squirrels in our garden, so I miss that. I miss all the wild animals, and unfortunately, we don't seem to have that many squirrels in Portugal.
Okay, let's check our answers. Number 1, Richard lives in Foz, in Porto, now. Number 2, yeah, he lives close to the river and the ocean. Number 3, Foz is more dangerous. Are you surprised? Number 4, in Roslyn Heights, in New York, people kept their shutters open. And number 5, he misses the city, speaking English, the birds, and the squirrels. How similar or different is Richard's neighborhood to yours? Look at the Venn diagram. Compare your neighborhood to Richard's. In the middle of the diagram, write what's similar to both. The city of New York is also known as the big something. It's a fruit. Do you know what it is? That's right. It's the Big Apple. Now read and listen to these fun facts about New York. Did you know that the first Europeans in New York City were the Dutch? Until 1664, the city was called New Amsterdam. When the British took over the city, it was renamed New York in honor of the Duke of York. The Statue of Liberty was a gift from the French in 1886. Close to 4 million people visit it each year. New York City is made up of 5 boroughs: Manhattan, the Bronx, Queens, Brooklyn, and Staten Island. And Queens was named after Catherine of Braganza, a Portuguese princess who married King Charles II. When King Charles took New York from the Dutch, he gave Queen Catherine some land and called it Queens. More than 800 languages are spoken in New York, which makes it the most diverse city in the world. Which fact did you find the most interesting? For me, it's the fact that more than 800 languages are spoken there. It's a multicultural city. Now look at the pictures in Exercise B and find the names of these places in the Fun Facts text. The Statue of Liberty is number 2. The Brooklyn Bridge is number 5. The Empire State Building is number 4. Central Park is number 3. Times Square is number 1. And the Guggenheim Museum is number 6. Now we're going to watch a video of New York. And which of these places can you see in the video?
New York is situated in the northeast region of the United States of America. Over 8 million people call the Big Apple home, and the city attracts up to 50 million visitors a year. Ever since the colonists arrived in 1624, New York has been continuously shaped by the waves of immigrants drawn here by the promise of hope and liberty. Every newcomer arrived with a cultural suitcase that contributed to the sounds, tastes, and textures of New York. But it is their dreams which built the city, a city like no other. New York touches not only the heavens with its mythic skyline, its influence radiates to every corner of the globe. Every street corner, it seems, is familiar through documentary, movie, and song. New York's straightforward grid system makes it an easy city to explore by foot, taxi, or on its subway, which, just like the city, never sleeps. In Manhattan's Midtown, you'll find many of the Big Apple's most iconic symbols. The Art Deco-designed Empire State Building is one of the most impressive and endearing skyscrapers ever created. The skyline may have grown up around it, but the view from the 102nd floor is as breathtaking today as it was when it first opened in 1931. New York has always been a place where, when the going got tough, the tough got going. The Rockefeller Center, a visionary city within a city, rose during the darkest days of the Great Depression. Today, it's still a place of creativity, inspiration, and even more incredible views of the city. Closer to Earth is Grand Central Terminal. Step into the main concourse and feel the echo of every tearful farewell and joyous greeting throughout the station's history. New York has always been the gateway to the land of the free, but it is also the city of the spree, the shopping spree. The city is shopaholic heaven, and Fifth Avenue, with its eye-popping window displays, is the high temple of the retail world. Times Square, one of the most visited tourist attractions on the planet. Stand here on the corner of Broadway and 7th Avenue, and you stand at the crossroads of the world. It's also the place to snap up a half-price ticket to a Broadway show. New York has been blessed with generous civic spaces. But there is no greater chill-out space in the Big Apple than Central Park, a beautiful 850-acre network of meadows and lakes. This is the place where New Yorkers come to rest, romance, and express themselves. Over the decades, many New Yorkers made it big, and much of that fabulous wealth was reinvested into collecting some of the greatest artworks on the planet. Nowadays, much of this art is available for everyone to enjoy. A walk through the Metropolitan Museum of Art is a walk through 5,000 years of humankind's greatest creative moments. The Frank Lloyd Wright-designed Guggenheim is a different kind of walk, one which spirals ever upward through a dizzying collection of 20th, and 21st century masterpieces. Newcomers to New York spend much of their time looking skyward, but since the 2001 attacks on the World Trade Center, a new attraction gives locals and visitors a chance to pause and bow their heads. The Reflecting Absence Memorial and Museum honors the 3,000 people who lost their lives on that darkest of September days. New York resonates with the sounds of over 800 language groups, and nothing epitomizes this diversity like the city's neighborhoods. Little Italy packs all the tastes and flavors of Italy into just a couple of streets, while Soho attracts cool cats and well-heeled bohemians from all over the world. A few streets away, Greenwich Village proudly retains the cafes and bars where creative residents like Bob Dylan first performed before becoming American icons. And then there are the boroughs. Walk across the Brooklyn Bridge to the melting pot of Brooklyn, with its own distinctive neighborhoods, museums, open spaces, and who could forget Coney Island? So welcome to New York City, the Big Apple. We've only just given you a bite-sized taste of what this incredible city has to offer. But if you've got an appetite for the very best things that life has to offer, this is the destination for you. There's enough to feast on here for a lifetime.
Places could you see? What would you like to visit? Choose five places to visit or things to do. Now, remember that question at the beginning? If you could live in any city in the world, which city would you choose? Well, would you change your answer now? Would you like to live in New York? I hope you've enjoyed your visit to New York. I know I have. And maybe we can get together again one day to travel to another place. I hope so.